Hello guys and welcome back to my channel. In this video I'm going to be talking about the Aprilia RSV4. This is one of those motorcycles which is very underrated, I should say. This bike deserves a lot more attention than it is seeking now. So if you see at the later class, many of them are familiar only with the R1s, S1000RR, or the Fireblades, ZX10R, or the Ducati V4. All these motorcycles are pretty famous, whereas the RSV4, I feel like it is so much ignored, I should say. So in this video I'm going to be talking about this bike. So I will tell you the importance and some of its achievements, which makes it one of the most important and one of the most attention gaining motorcycle which you will feel after watching this video. If you are familiar with the leader class section, it is a 1000cc V4 engine, and this was one of the first bike to release in a V4 configuration in leader class section. So it was launched in 2009, but after 2009 it straight up went into World Superbike Championships. This bike was built for winning. So since its launch, it has been participating in several races and it has won 9 international races. So it has been on the podium for 9 times. And so in terms of specs, this is as I told you, it is a 1000cc V4 configured engine at 65 degrees, but if you upgrade it to some acropoic or whichever suitable exhaust system, and if you flash the ACV, you can get easily 10 horsepower more. It is a 6-speed transmission, wet clutch, not a dry clutch. The in terms of braking, it has two 320 mm Brembo monoblock radial 4-piston calipers at the front, and at the rear it has a 220 mm diameter disc which is also Brembo 2-piston caliper. In terms of tire size, the front is 120 by 70 17 inch tires, and at the rear it has a 200 section tire also 17 inch in the diameter. The wheelbase is 59.9 inch, and the seat height is at 845 mm. Now the initial model had only 184.5 horsepower, but and it was not a impressive stat until they upgraded it at 2016. So till 2016, from 2009 all the 7-year model has been the same with minor tweaks, and it had been producing the same amount of power, which is 184.5 horsepower, which was not a lot, but the most important thing is its dry weight. The dry weight of this motorcycle is 179 kgs. Now that's the most important thing, because if you compare the horsepower to weight ratio, it is very high compared to other motorcycles when this bike was launched. So after that, if anyone had upgraded to a titanium exhaust system, the weight would come to 175 or to 174 kilos, which was almost the weight of my CBR 250R, with all the with even if I have a half tank, it would weigh the same. And after 2009, when it was launched and started participating in World Superbike Championships, the first year it was not able to win, but this was recognized by so many people, and they thought it would give a tough competition in the next year. And that's what it did. It won World Superbike Championship in 2010, 2012, and in 2014, I think. In past 10 years, it has won 3 World Superbike Championship, and it has won FIM Superstock 1000 Cup season as well in 2015. So if you see the top championship seasons, it has won 4 in last 10 years. This is a big statement from Aprilia, because this motorcycle company is not a huge company like Ducati or Kawasaki, Honda, Yamaha or BMW, because all the races or the championship it has won is against all these big, big companies. So you can see the amount of technology or the amount of racing ability that this bike possesses. After that, the bike has been the same till 2015, and it got revised and it was updated in 2016. The power figure was raised to 195.5 horsepower, and the weight was still the same. I don't know how they did it, but the weight was still the same, and they raised the power to 195.5 bhp, and same like the older models, if you upgraded it to a titanium exhaust, it would cross 200 bhp easily. So again, the horsepower to weight ratio increased much higher, and this was loved by the track enthusiast. And when it was upgraded in 2016, there were two models especially which was divided this bike into. One was the RR and one was the RF. Both have the same engine, but and same specs. The part where these both were differentiated was in terms of equipments. When you purchase an RF version, the RR version had everything, but when you upgrade it to RF version, you would get carbon fiber fender, carbon fiber rail tail, rear hugger, and lots of carbon fiber parts, and some minor tweaks, and the suspension upgrades. I don't know why people still don't recognize the amount of ability that this bike has, and still they are purchasing the ZX10Rs, the R1s, and lots of other little class motorcycles when you have such an amazing motorcycle. The reason why it did not get succeed is the marketing, which is, I should say, was very poor by Aprilia. The only bike which is famous in India is the Aprilia SR125 and SR150, which are not bikes also. They are the mopeds for the lower cc segments. And this company deserves a lot more, man. The new 2020 Aprilia RSV4. I'm 100% sure it can beat any bike in this world in track. So in terms of specs, the 1100 factory has 217 horsepower. Now that's a big jump from 195.5 horsepower to 217 directly, because it has gained 100 more cc on its 1000 cc engine already. And Aprilia has succeeded in improving the power as well. So 217 horsepower is more than enough, I think, to beat any bike in this world, and it depends on the rider as well. So this is the most amazing thing in this bike, and it has been continuing this from its launch, which is its weight. Man, this bike already comes stock with a titanium acrylic exhaust, and this weighs only about 175 kgs from the factory. So you can imagine the amount of power to weight ratio that this bike has. This bike will turn everyone's head whenever it is displayed in front of people who know about bikes. That's all with this video, guys. If you find it useful, make sure you subscribe to my channel, and stay at home, stay safe. Peace.